The content presentation are error recovery strategies, types and details, and YAC. And we also have the structure of YAC, followed by some gate questions. The first slide has about, we are explaining about error recovery. A parser should be able to detect and report any error in the program. This is done in the form of error recovery. It is expected that when an error is encountered, the parser should be able to handle it and carry on parsing the rest of the input. Mostly it is expected from the parser to check for errors, but errors may be encountered at various stages of the compilation process. We will further go to the error recovery strategies. We have different types of error recovery strategies. That is, there are four common strategies that can be implemented in the parser. That the first is panic mode recovery. Then we have phrase level recovery, error productions, and global correction. First, we will explain about panic mode recovery. Once an error is found, the parser intends to find designated set of synchronizing tokens by discarding input symbols one at a time. Then, that is, synchronizing tokens are delimiters, semicolon, whose role in source program is clear. The first point of panic mode recovery is when parser finds an error in the statement, it ignores the rest of the statement by not processing the input. This is the easiest way of error recovery. It prevents the parser from developing infinite loops. Here we have an example to explain the same. In case of an error like that is given in the following example, the compiler will discard all subsequent tokens till a semicolon is encountered. Here is an example of a structure of a parser developed using Plex and Bison. That is, first we get the input text. Yes. First we get the input text, the lexical rules, and then the flex, and then it goes to the parser. From the parser, it goes into the scanner. Then we get the C compiler that in turn goes as an input to the parser. We have different paths through which we can reach our goal. We also have the grammar rules that will enter into Bison, which will further get into scanner, and then we will follow the regular steps that we did last time. So now we will talk about phrase level recovery. It performs local correction on the remaining input. A typical local correction, what it does, it replaces a comma by a semicolon. It deletes an extraneous semicolon and it also inserts a missing semicolon. Now we will talk about error productions. The productions which generate errorless constructs are augmented to the grammar by considering common errors that occur. These productions detect the anticipated errors during parsing. Error diagnostics about the errorless constructs are generated by the parser. Here we have an example that demonstrates error productions. Next, we will talk about global correction. In global correction, the compiler has to make few changes as possible in processing an incorrect input string. For example, given an incorrect input string X and grammar G, algorithms will find a parse tree for a related string Y, such that the number of insertions, deletions, and changes of tokens required to transform X into Y is as small as possible. Next, we will talk about the YACC. The YAC generates C for syntax analyzer of parser. YAC uses grammar rules that allows it to analyze token from lex and create a syntax tree. It also provides a general tool for describing the input to a computer program. The YAC user specifies the structure of his input together with code to be invoked as each, such structure is recognized. Here we will see the structure of the YAC programs. It first consists of declarations, then it has rules or the conditions, and then it has the functions, auxiliary functions. Here we have a diagram which clearly demonstrates the combining of the flex, wig or bison. In the first part we see the YAC specification, which is written as yak.y. It is given to the bison compiler, which in turn produces y.tab.c program and y.tab.h. In the next part we see the lex specification, which is written as lex.l, and the token definitions, which is written as y.tab.h, is given to the flex compiler, and it in turn produces lex.yy.c. In next we see the lex.yy.c and the y.tab.c is given as input to the C compiler, which produces a.out. Then the input stream is provided into the a.out and we get the output stream. Next we have the gate questions. The first question is, which of the following is not error recovery strategy? Option A, panic mode. Option B, phrase level recovery. Option C, error production. Option D, phrase recognition. Answer is option D, phrase recognition. The next question is, for phrase level recovery, which of the following is true? Option A, replacing comma by semicolon. Option B, deletion of semicolon. Option C, inserting missing semicolon. Option D, all of these. And the answer is option D, all of these. Here we have the third question. The advantage of panic mode of error recovery is that option A, it is simple to implement. Option B, it never gets into an infinite loop. Option C, both option A and B, and option D, none of these. And the answer is option C, both A and B. Now we move on to the fourth question. The YAC takes C code as input and outputs dash. Option A, top-down parsers. Option B, bottom-up parsers. Option C, machine code. Option D, none of the mentioned. And the answer is option B, bottom-up parsers. The explanation being, the YAC takes the C code as input and produces shift reduce parsers in C, also known as bottom-up parser, execute C snippets with the associated rule.
Thank you, Devalina, Annisha.
In this video, I will explain about YAC in compiler design. First, let us see the full form of YAC. It is yet another compiler. It was developed by Steven C. Johnson. What is a YAC? It is a tool for generating look ahead left to right, that is LALR parser. It does the same work as Lex does in lexical analyzer. It takes input from the lexical analyzer and generates the parse tree. Then we have the working of YAC. It has three steps in the working. We have a block diagram to explain it. Firstly, input to the YAC compiler will be a file with .y extension. It will contain desired grammar in YAC format. YAC compiler will convert it into a C code in the form of y.tab.c file, that is a C file. Then this y.tab.c file will be given as an input to the C compiler and the output will be the LALR parser, that is given as a.out. Tokens generated by the lexical analyzer using the lex tool will be given as an input to a.out, that is our LALR parser, and we will get the parse tree as output. This is how the YAC works in compiler design. Then here we have the syntax of YAC. It is similar to the syntax of LEX in lexical analysis. First, we have the definitions and declarations in the form of tokens. Then we have some rules to be followed in YAC. That is, the head, we have body 1, which performs one action. And then we have action 2, action 3, similarly for different parts of the statement. Then we have the auxiliary routines, that is, which is given in the form of C code.
Excellent. Thank you, Deblina. Thank you, Anisha. Excellent presentation. I must say this is a, you took a different topic. First of all, compiler is a very challenging topic. You have taken the first time the error reproduction and error correction and all these things. First of all, we have to understand where comes the role of error detection, and where error detection much easier. Any code data transfer also, error correction is very costly operation. You have to pack, if you're doing data transmission, you see a lot of data had to be added. It is for, I'm calling data transmission. But where is the error correction is required? Sometimes, say in satellite communication, maybe you want to start a program at a remote places like a remote computer at maybe at Mars. Then probably your compiler should have some error recovery. But error recovery is too costly and it will be too much heavy. Error detection. First of all, error detection also, the first is panic mode. Panic mode means whenever compiler gets first error, it just comes out. So that is the easiest to implement. But sometimes compiler generally, whenever it passes, you know, the first is go for lexical analysis and then the syntax analysis. Most of the errors, some of the errors comes at the even the lexical analysis. That is whenever you have some problem with white spaces and this and this. Lexical analysis phase that can correct those phases, and then the syntax analysis major burden, and another error comes that is called the semantic analysis, like whenever you forgetfully put a floating point number, a string or string to a floating point number, that is a casting related all errors that will be detected not at syntax analysis phase, that is semantics analysis phase. So error comes at all, because this is analysis phase, error comes. So it is better to, if you get only one error and it comes out, then it is a very impractical, then the compilation, loading and all these things. So it will be recommended that if a missing semicolon or missing bracket, a compiler try to guess it as if the missing semicolon is there in C and Java, and the bracket mismatching, it suggests something, but it goes on for a few many steps. So that is the role of error detection. You remember the last, all the error detection, all error can come at any stage that I've told. And compiler also very complex topic, because your hardware is changing and changing. Right now you start from one diamond, then the RISC architecture, right now that GPU graphics processing, there are now the tensor processing unit are coming. These are the hardware scenarios. You may be, you know, one mobile phone, you have a four core CPUs or eight CPUs. Octa-core is pretty common right now. And then the laptop also, you maybe have eight cores. And so you have too much hardware set there. And your language is also changing. It is not like C. It is, all this as C language, you have talked about yet another compiler like YAC or Bison or Flex. The compiler language is also mostly now an interpreted language, like, you know, Python and like this. So the languages are changing, differences, it can be run at any place, anywhere, the hardware is changing. So compiler's role is much more demanding. So highest brains in computer science may be taken up by the Google and the Oracle, and those are developing the interpreter and compiler. It's a very pretty fundamental subject. So that's it. So excellent presentation, and also your